This fight may be big in the UK, but here in the US, I don't think anybody's excited about it. Anyone's looking forward to it. Conor Benn against Chris Eubanks Jr. It's two UK legends, the sons of two UK legends going at it. Of course, Conor Benn had that failed drug test, blamed the eggs on it, but he's cleared, I think, to fight now. I'm not sure what's the latest on that. I think that's what's the clearest. And then Chris Eubanks Jr. had Bomek in his corner and he beat. He stopped Smith in a rematch when the first one he lost. So you see, rematches could change the outcome. And then people are saying now Liam Smith was injured in the second half of the fight and twisted his ankle. In the end of the day, that doesn't matter. You win, you lose, and it is what it is. Eddie Hearn says, Eubank versus Ben, absolutely massive. In the UK, he needs to add. Because, correct me if I'm wrong, yesterday I was trying to fight. Usually when there's fights on the road, I call different boxing people and say if I could go chill with them and watch a fight. Not one person that I know watched a fight yesterday. I'm talking about fighters, trainers, managers, promoters. Anybody I reached out to, it just wasn't that fight. So, in the UK, they love boxing. It's a big UK fight. In the US, I don't think Chris Eubanks or Conor Benn really have an impact. Now, correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, guys. I'm not hating on anyone. I'm just keeping it 100. There's a difference. Hating is saying something personal or saying something about their fighting style. I'm just saying they're just not. Nobody cares. If they fought in the U.S., they wouldn't sell one ticket. I'm keeping it 100. And then Paulie Malignaggi always has a good sense of humor. They ask, Eubank versus Ben, absolutely massive. He's responding to Eddie Hearn, amount of HGH. Paulie, for years, has been a big advocate about clean sports, about steroids, about drug testing in boxing. He's been a champion for that cause going back 12, 15 years, ever since the topic really was talked about heavily, and nothing ever happens. Like I said, VADA is not the answer to me. VADA is another entity that says voluntary nonprofit, but the tests are too outrageously expensive to test everyone 0-0 to 50-0. What VADA should do is spend 2 years without charging anyone and test every fighter that's registered right now for the next 2 years, 0-0 to 50-0. And then 2 years of cleaning out the sport kind of weed out a lot of the ones they use. And if you get caught, then I think there should be some kind of standard among the ABC, which is the organization of all the promoters, that if you get caught failing a drug test, there's a mandatory, whether it's 2, 3, 4 year, whatever the ban is. I mean, there may be some extreme circumstances where someone is innocent and took something not knowingly, but often, too often, we hear excuses when people get busted. So stay tuned. Ellie Setback reporting.
ESPNNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Setback reporting.
ESPNNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Setback reporting.